SCQA can be thought of as the scientific method for business problem solving. I'll walk you through what the acronym stands for, how you can use it in solving problems at work or in a consulting project you're working on independently, and some examples of how we might apply it to real-world situations. First, let's walk through the acronym. SCQA stands for Situation, Complication, Question, and Answer. Let's go through each one by one. Situation is where you agree on the current state of the problem. This is a set of facts that you agree on either with a client or the team you're working with. The complication is the reason you're working on this problem to begin with. What changed? What shifted? What's the tension? Was there an internal change? An external change? This is where you really want to get clear on what was the current state, situation, and then what changed, and what's requiring you to focus on this in the first place. Let's pause here for a quick example. Let's look at the situation of our friends over the ocean, Brexit. In 2016, they voted to leave the European Union. This is the situation. We can agree on that set of facts. That happened. However, the complication is that this is an unprecedented event. No one really knows how to react to this. So combining the situation and the complication, you can define a problem statement, something challenging, that you can then address in a structured problem-solving process. Question is about identifying the hypotheses. These are the questions which will shape your exploration. You want to check out accompanying videos I link out below on MISI and the Pyramid Principle, which will go into more depth about how you should think about structuring and organizing your ideas and hypotheses. But for this video, we really want to just focus on the idea of questions as hypotheses. And then finally, A, these are the answers. We don't mean an ultimate answer, like an ultimate source of truth, but instead an answer to the questions we created, the hypotheses. This will give us an indication of whether to react or not react based on what we find. So if you ask a question such as, do we need to add more members to the team? You might perform research and find that you do, in fact, need to add people to the team if you want to meet your goals, and that would be the answer. SCQA is a great process for breaking down complex problems and structuring them in a way that can lead you to break up different research work streams and come up with answers that are really actionable to either confirm or disprove the hypothesis you develop. The important parts of SCQA are really the team process and confirming and aligning around what actually is the problem. Have you defined the problem sufficiently and accurately and in a way that everyone agrees on it? Can you define the questions in a structured way such that they're MISI? They're separate, they're independent questions, but together they collectively help break down the whole problem. And then answers. Can you come up with answers that prove or disprove the hypotheses such that you can figure out what to do next, you can tell your team what to do, you can figure out what to do at work, or you can tell your client what to do next. Let's tie this back to the consulting process to close. SC is really defining the problem. You can see this in green. And then in blue, the Q is the questions. These are the hypotheses. And A in red, this is the answer, the recommendations. I wish you luck in applying this tool to the problems you're solving in the business world, or hopefully this just helped you gain a deeper level of understanding of different approaches of how to approach complex problems. If you want to explore more, you can check out the course, check out the links for Think Like a Strategy Consultant, or check us out at strategyu.co.